Hey everyone, welcome back to Pajama Crafts, where I do crafts in my pajamas. Today I have three Dollar Tree Christmas DIYs for you, and I am loving these. I hope you do too. For the first one here, I'm using this piece of decor from Dollar Tree that was obviously for fall. I tried to peel off as much of the paper as possible. It was a little bit difficult, so I ended up just sanding the rest down until it was as smooth as I could possibly get it. Next, I'm taking this piece of Christmas scrapbook paper I got from In Love Arts. I will try to leave the link in the description. And I just traced around the box to get the size that I needed. Next, I'm using some Mod Podge and just brushing that on there with a sponge brush. And I also brushed some onto my paper as well. And then I just stuck it down on there and got out as many bubbles as I possibly can. I know I've heard so many things about spraying the paper and things like that. I kind of forgot about it or just was... Sometimes I just get in a zone and this one I was trying to finish as fast as I could before Brie woke up because she likes to get to my cords and things with my hot glue gun and now I have a ring light and just all that kind of stuff, and I try to get done as quickly as possible. Now I let the paper dry for a little while before I did my top coat of Mod Podge. Now I got these garland ties from Dollar Tree, and I'm just taking two and kind of twisting them together to make it a little bit thicker for my little makeshift wreath. Then I just hot glued it down. Now, taking this ornament I got from Dollar Tree, I just went ahead and cut off the whole string, and then I hot glued that to my wreath. What's up, girl? Now, I know I should have done this before I put my second coat of Mod Podge on, but I completely forgot. But I'm just taking a little bit of sandpaper and trying to get those edges a little bit because it did hang over just a tad. And so I'm just rubbing those away. And it did make a little bit of a distressed look, which I like too. This I probably also should have done before I added my embellishments and everything, but I just decided I wanted the edges of this black to go better with that plaid. And so I am taking my Waverly chalk paint in the color ink and just painting that all along the edges. That's Brie roaring that you hear. And then I did end up taking some on the corners and just smearing it a little bit to get a little bit more of that distressed and older worn feeling. This one might be my favorite. I really, really like how it turned out. So for this next one, I'm using a DIY that I did for fall. I really didn't like how it turned out, especially with the bow on top. The leaf was okay, but I just decided to repurpose it. So I ripped off that leaf and the bow, and then it left a little bit of residue from the glue, or actually pulled up a little bit of the, you know, layer that was there. Anyway, I decided to repaint it with my white paint. I think it's just called white from Waverly, and I just gave the whole entire thing a nice coat. Now I've been seeing I cannot talk this morning. This is literally the next morning from when I did the first DIY because Brie was just getting too crazy, and then she was flinging her arms in the air and she scratched me in the face, and I was like, okay, this is waiting till tomorrow. So anyway, this is the next morning. Sorry about my voice. Brie is not even awake yet, and I just want to get it done before she wakes up. But I've been seeing a lot of people doing like the 25 thing for Christmas for December 25th, and I think it's pretty cute, so that's just what I decided to do on this one, keep it real simple. So I am just using one of my Posca paint pens and a stencil from Walmart and writing 25. Next, I just glued that middle piece back in with my hot glue, and then we're going to do some embellishments. These are the garland ties from Dollar Tree, and I just cut off two pieces about the same size, and I'm hot gluing those down, and then I have like 3 million pine cones that my dad gave me a couple years ago, and I was like, I need a few pine cones, and he delivered. So I have an endless amount of pine cones. I will never need another pine cone. I don't even know where he got them. I don't remember, but he showed up. Let's just say that. So, just using one of the little pine cones that he brought me, and then I decided to put a little bit of that white paint on the edges of the garland and the pine cone just to make it look a little prettier and, like, had some snow on it. This one turned out very cute and simple, and I think I like it. Now, for the last DIY, I'm using another one of these frames from Dollar Tree. I really like these. They're like chipboard or something, a little more sturdy and not the plastic that you usually see at Dollar Tree. They're not a regular frame because you have to pop out that middle piece, but I'm just adding a piece of chicken wire to the back. I've had this for a long time and I'm just trying to use it up. It's very difficult to work with because it's real chicken wire. I would suggest getting the decorative chicken wire from Walmart if they still have it. I've never got it before, but I hear that it's much easier to work with. And I think it looks kind of cute because it has like it's a little bit like that rusty look, but that's just me. And then you could definitely glue it down if you wanted to, but I find it easier to use this staple gun that I have from Walmart. So next, I'm adding this Dollar Tree ornament. I'm just cutting off the string so that is not in the way, and I just hot glue that down to the right-hand corner. I've seen some things similar to this on Pinterest, so say like Joy or something, going down the side of the frame, but it's just open, and I just really like the look of the chicken wire with it. I don't know, I think it's just like an extra added element that makes it look more rustic and very cute. Now, these two picks are from Dollar Tree. I think they're beautiful, so I grabbed them right away. And I have this bell from Dollar Tree as well, just pulling off a few of those little strands that are kind of stringy. And then I just actually removed the hanging string on the bell. It's really easy, you can just pull it out the side. And then I decided to cut down the ends of my picks, just so they were not in the way. It was a little bit difficult because my tool is like so small, but that has nothing to do with anyone else. I'm sure you'll do fine with it. So then I just glued those down. I put a little bit of glue on the bottom, and then I just added a bunch of glue on top of the stems after I put them down, just to make sure that they really held well. And then to cover up the crisscross of those two stems, that's kind of ugly where I cut the ends, I just got a few more of the pine cones from my stash from my dad and added those at the top. Shout out to my dad because he is always saving stuff for me to use on my channel. Appreciate you, Dad. And then I am just hot gluing my bell down to the big pile of greenery right there, and it stayed just fine. I have done this in the past and the bell came off of the hot glue. I don't know if you guys have any tips of what kind of glue I should use on that metal, just let me know, but I think this thing came out adorable. Now, when I was trying to take a picture of the finished product, Koi says, "Oh, let me be in the picture." And then and then they decided to try to be in all the pictures. But yeah, anyway, these are my two cuties. Love them to death. I love to share them with you guys. But this is how everything turned out. This is kind of how I set it up. I'm not going to leave it like this because I haven't decorated for Christmas yet, but just wanted to give you guys an idea of how it could look. I don't have a tiered tray. I really need one for all these small things, but I like how they look in my little Hobby Lobby thingy. I don't know what it's called, but let me know which one was your favorite. Like this video, subscribe. I love you guys, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!